What is a 1099? In this video, we're gonna be talking about 1099s, especially within the context of independent contractors, which are not considered to be employees of the business, but receive compensation for their work, just like employees do. Hi everyone, I'm Hector Garcia. I'm a CPA, QuickBooks consultant, and business owner. I'm a big fan of Intuit QuickBooks, and I'm partnering with them to produce this video series about payroll. In fact, I have an entire YouTube channel where I have tons of videos about QuickBooks, accounting, tax, and a bunch of important things for small businesses. Hit the like button if you're interested in seeing more videos with these topics. Today, we're gonna be talking about Form 1099 NEC, which is a very important form for both you and your contractors. NEC stands for Non-Employee Compensation, and the Form 1099 NEC is how businesses report to the IRS the compensation paid to the independent contractor during the tax year. And if they're not filled out correctly or timely, there could be costly consequences, penalties for the business. And additionally, if the independent contractors themselves do not report that income to the IRS, there could be issues for the contractor as well. Every year around January, the businesses will submit a 1099 NEC to the IRS and give a copy to their contractors. The reportable annual threshold is $600. So if an independent contractor is paid less than that during the entire year, it is unlikely that they will get a 1099 NEC form from that business. So what's on the 1099 NEC? They contain six important pieces of information. First, you got the payer's company name, the payer's company address, the payer's tax ID or EIN. Then we're gonna have the recipient's social security number if the contractor happens to be an individual, or an EIN if the contractor is a business. It also contains the total compensation paid to the contractor during the tax year. And also, if there's tax withheld on those payments, that will be reported as well, but that's very rarely used. It's important to note that there are many different types of Form 1099s out there. There is 1099s MISC or 1099 miscellaneous, 1099C, 1099B, 1099K, 1099DIV, 1099G, and others. These additional 1099 forms report other types of income, such as rental payments, cancellation of debt, interest, dividends, and unemployment benefits. In many cases, that could be taxable income to the person that receives it. Now let's talk about the right process to pay and report 1099s for contractors as a small business, because there are several steps involved here. First, make sure your contractor fills out Form W-9. This is the formal document where the contractor provides the business their legal name and tax information. It is recommended that you do not make a payment to the independent contractor until you receive that W-9 form, especially when the cumulative amount of the year reaches $600. It is recommended to also have a legal contract that underpins the relationship between the contractor and the business, that lays out the payment terms, independence between the parties, combination of the contract with dates and responsibilities under the contract. Make sure to seek help from an attorney on this matter. Next, you may pay your contractor using whichever method you prefer: cash, check, direct deposit, cash transfer apps, etc. Your options include here using payroll software like Intuit QuickBooks. Make sure you keep strong records of when and how these payments were disbursed. If the W-9 contains a voluntary withholding, or you have received instructions from the IRS to withhold money from those payments, make sure you keep that in mind before actually issuing those payments. And finally, you will want to fill out a Form 1099 NEC for each contractor and report the total compensation for the year. Now that you've filled out the 1099 NEC, let's talk about how to file it or report it to the IRS. There are two ways to do this. You can do it via US Postal Mail or electronically using e-filing. E-filing is typically the easiest and fastest way to report your 1099s. If you're a QuickBooks user, you may already be a fan of e-filing, as QuickBooks allows users to auto-import those details from the contractors into those forms. And also, users can print and send those copies to the contractors so they can submit it to the IRS timely. Additionally, if you use QuickBooks Payroll, the first three 1099 forms are actually free. Now that you have a better understanding of 1099s, you're better equipped to handle your contractors' tax information. I would like to quickly summarize a few best practices. One, collect your contractor's information using that W-9 form early on to avoid the stress of the deadlines. I suggest that you make it a requirement to get that W-9 form filled out and signed prior from making the first payment to the contractor, even if the dollar amount is under $600. That should help speed up the process. Make sure to add in your calendar the important dates related to any tax or form submission deadlines. Three, when possible, avoid paying the contractor in cash. Try to use a check or a digital form of payment to leave a paper trail that will make the process easier when reporting those 1099s at year end. Four, keep good records of who you are paying and for what purpose. This is where having a great bookkeeping system like QuickBooks could help immensely. Five, leverage your bookkeeping system to electronically file these forms. For example, QuickBooks has an add-on service that takes all your contractor and payment information and automatically generates the forms for you to get them ready for electronic filing. Again, I'm Hector Garcia, and thanks for joining me in this video. Leave a comment below and let me know if you have any other questions about 1099s or any other payroll topic. If you found this information helpful, make sure to click that like button, subscribe to the QuickBooks YouTube channel, and ring the notification bell. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.